First, playing Virgil Brooks in Trumbo is Adewale Akinnoye Agbaje. Thank you. Playing Dalton Trumbo is Brian Cranston. Playing Heather Hopper, Helen Mirren. And playing Frank King, John Goodman. Very much for Trumbo, a film which I'm sure everyone here has seen, many of you probably just this morning actually. Insightful, I think, and importantly also entertaining movie which celebrates the importance of artistic independence. A quick question from me to begin with. I think we'll all agree, having seen it, you agree, having made it, that it's important and that it explores a shameful episode of American and Hollywood history, and that alone makes it worth exploring. But I'm keen to know what each of you feel the more modern resonances you felt the film had that made it important to make now and for people to watch and think about it now. What do you think makes Trumbo an urgent film?
Well, I think it, the message resonates internationally. Anytime a government overreaches its powers to oppress the free civil rights of its citizenry, that's cause for alarm. And it happened in the United States. It breached what our First Amendment to the Constitution states as free speech. And a man went to prison for a year for committing no crime. And I think that's certainly worth a story. And as a cautionary tale, I think hopefully it will resonate internationally.
It's a small section of the government exploiting the fear and propagating paranoia to the people, and it feeds upon itself. And it is a cautionary tale because it's happening now.
I would say that in the context of the character that I play, Hedda Hopper, like you guys, a journalist, and especially in the light of what's happened within the press and journalism here in this country in the last 3 or 4 years, it is also a story about the fearful power of the press and the way it can be, in a sense, misused, or at least when the press engages so immediately, if that's the right way of putting it, with the zeitgeist, is that the right word? Of the time, instead of challenging the zeitgeist. You know, my character just plays with the power of her journalism, plays to the fears and the paranoia of her public, and it is I think it shows us how very dangerous that power can be.
Thank you. A question to Brian and to John as American actors. These events happened long before you started out as young actors, but I'm keen to know that when you were both starting out in the 70s and 80s as young actors, could you still feel the shockwaves of these events in your industry in terms of divisions, lingering resentments, stories that you heard from probably older colleagues?
From older actors, yeah. When I started out in the mid-70s, there was a lot of older actors had friends or that were themselves touched by the scare, which ended 15 years before I started. There was still a great deal of resentment. And I grew up studying the tenets of the group theater, and they were especially devastated by the HUAC. And a lot of people I contacted were affected.
I can't honestly say no, that when I started, it wasn't a topic of conversation. John, being several years my senior, certainly that he was around during those days, and remembers them firsthand.
Let's start taking
questions. Can I just say that we, of course, in Britain, when I first came into the industry, we, in a sense, in Britain benefited because some of the directors, in particular, I'm thinking of Joseph Losey, who, as I understand, was one of the, one of the people who had to leave America. And, of course, we benefited in Europe from the brilliance of those directors. You know, Joe Losey, when I was first, and I would have died to work with Joe Losey. He was the sort of preeminent art film director in working in Britain. So, that was an immediate sort of outfall of that time.
Thank you. Can I start taking questions, please? I'll set two or three up. There's one here. You can get the microphone here, and I can see one down here.
Hi, I'm Nick Hiffer from Montreal. The question's for Brian Cranston. The octopus and mesmerizing characters with insatiable dialogue. Trumbo, in particular, is a man renowned for his witticisms and eloquent vocabulary. What's your personal favorite Trumbo quote or Trumboism and why? Also, my fat mate is dying to know. We make an ultimate cameo in Botback also, would you say?
I don't know if a cameo is in the works for Better Call Saul for my character. Could be, and I certainly would do it if Vince Gilligan wanted me to. I would absolutely do that. As far as a Trumbo witticism, I think the phrase that keeps ringing in my ears really is emblematic of the message in Trumbo. And that is the moment when Trumbo addresses John Wayne and says, we just have a different opinion, and that's the point. We both have the right to be wrong.
Thank you.